bass preamp and DI. I made a bunch of upgrades and some additions here for additional tone control. With the overall design, I went to a fully polypropylene filter capacitor supply, which gives you a lot more, makes the tone a lot cleaner, more articulate, less kind of nasty distortion artifacts, very high fidelity, you can hear it, but you still have the tube warmth. Just gives you a lot of really clarity and sonic detail. I'm on the front panel here, and this is just a prototype, but you've got input and mute, your input here, and then your thru jack, and then added a variable impedance control here, so you can sweep it far to the left, is for like active instruments, and then somewhere up in the middle is typical what you find with passive, and then if you go all the way to the right, it raises the input impedance very high, which would be suitable for piezo equipped instruments. Also added a tone control section here. Basically you have different boosts. There's an overall gain boost, and then a low boost and a high boost, and they all work a little bit differently. The overall gain boost comes earlier in the circuit, and it's pretty much a broadband boost. It gives you a little bit more aggressive of a tone, but it's not it doesn't boost down too low to where you get a lot of sub messy lows. And then the low boost is kind of nice. It's based off the Studio 1200's preamp. It's got an inductor bass boost, and then the high boost that adds detail to the upper mids and top end. And then the volume control and your power switch. So I'll run you through a few different settings here. I'm running through a Bergen B412 here. It's a sealed tweeterless cab, but I think you'll be able to still hear a lot of the detail from the upgrades. I'm running a USA Schecter PJ Ash Maple. It's another passive instrument. So I have the impedance just somewhere in the middle, since this is a passive instrument. It's kind of also cool control if you, I don't know if it'll pick it up here, it's subtle, but you can sweep it all the way to the left, and it loads the signal a little bit more, make it a little slightly bit darker and vintagey. You go all the way to the right, you may get a little bit more aggressive top end. So we'll just leave that right in the middle. So here it is, just with everything flat. Here's with just the P pickup. Here's the P with the pick. Back off, and then I'll do the same thing with the high boost here. Now we'll do the gain boost here as well. Thank you.
flip the gain on, you'll hear it just brings it, kind of fills out the mid range here. So you can kind of use them all engaged, I suppose. That would be similar probably to just using the gain boost by itself because it's a broader band, but I think probably engaging the low boost with it, you might get a little bit more low end, but I'd probably use the gain boost just to, if you wanted to know a little bit more overall aggressive tonality versus the frequency, what the frequency shaping switches give you. So there's a quick rundown. Also, it's uses one 6L7 and one 12AU7 running at very high voltage. And on the back, there is an unbalanced quarter inch out, a balanced XLR out, which uses a Jensen transformer, and then there's a groundless switch and the power cord and the